World, how would you feel speeding down a highway, weaving through traffic in a car you have no control of? Sounds like my daughter driving. What we're talking about, though, is driverless cars, and the UK has just begun testing them, along with an interesting vehicle they're calling a pod. CNN's Jim Bolden is in London with the details. Check it out.
Knight Rider, a shadowy flight into the dangerous world of a man who does not exist.
Michael Knight had one, a driverless car. Though Kitt had a host of sci-fi gadgets to help Knight fight crime. 30 years on, and this is more the reality of a driverless vehicle, a two-seater electric pod. These are expected to be running on designated pathways in the British city of Milton Keynes in coming years. Airports already have similar pods running on designated rails to and from terminals and parking lots, but they aren't running on city streets.
Car are able to take control.
And what about real cars with no drivers? Nissan and the University of Oxford already are testing actual driverless electric cars. To allay worries about safety, they've released video showing how cameras and sensors are used to stop the car. The engineers say their navigation system with an off-the-shelf computer adds less than $8,000 to the price of an auto. All controlled, not from a steering wheel, but from an iPad. Michael Knight may have gotten Kitt from a mysterious industrialist. Now the British government is offering $120 million to business to test a host of different low-carbon engines. $2.4 million on these driverless pedestrian pods. Coming soon to the town of Milton Keynes, the government wants 100 of these on pathways by 2017. Jim Bolden, CNN, London.